Before going on track, this should be the first modification you do to your bike, and I'll tell you why. So the year is 2015, and I've been riding for about 5 months at this point. I had only owned the bike for about a month and a half, maybe 2 months at most, and we're all the way in Arizona. So I get to the mountain, we start going up, maybe like 5 miles into the mountain. I crash the BMW. Guess what I did not have at that time? You guessed it, I did not have any crash protection. This case right here, they're made of out of some magnesium alloy. So what happened was, the road was so rough that this right here got a small hole in it. So this is not like a Tuono or some other bikes that have a little bit kind of like a crash protection deal going on from the factory. This one, if you crash, this is gonna touch down for sure, almost guaranteed. Let's say you're in a track day and you crash going really slowly in the middle of the track, and guess who's not going to be very happy? Everybody on that track day, because once you spill oil on track, man, it takes forever to clean up. This company, T-Rex, they're actually here in Texas. They're about 2.5 hours, 3 hours up from me. They're in Dallas. If you look for some protection, you have some options. This is actually made by Rizoma, but you can tell this is for the XR. You can tell this is all the protection is offering right there. And maybe that's all you need. And this is nice because it's small and lightweight. There is a certain case protector that covers the entire thing. And what happens is humidity starts getting behind there. So this one's got opening, got a little ventilation. So as you can see, these are like super easy to put on. And this doesn't take a lot of torque at all. That is it, now we're protected. I'm also going to be installing their sliders. And these are not gonna run on track, but I'm gonna be doing a lot of parking lot drills and, you know, any minor tip-overs, these are gonna protect great. Pretty straightforward install. The other side is even easier because it's only got one side or one bolt to put through, pretty long bolt. You could argue that with these, you don't even have to have these because look how much, how far they stick out. Something that you should be mindful of, and one of the first things you can do to any motorcycle, is get some radiator and all cooler protection. Because if you get a bouncing rock on the track, you open a hole in the radiator and now your day is ruined. What I'm gonna do to prevent that, I already have the radiator protector, but I'm also going to use a water-based coolant. Now, these you can make yourself, and this is something that I've done in the past. You can get some distilled water with the right mix of water weather, and you can run that. And then if you're concerned about the water pump or the lubricity, you can always just flush it out and put regular coolant in it. But I've run these for 15,000 miles on the BMW, and I haven't had any issues. Now, next on the list that we need to address are brakes. And for brakes, I'm going to be using this EVC EPFA 630. These are not really the race brake pads. The race brake pads are the GPFAX, and these I have run on the XR. I will be putting a new set of GPFAX on these ones once I take it to Kota, because these brakes are unreal. The GPFAX needs to be nice and hard to work perfect. This is more of a 50-50 track and street pad that you can run on the street. It's legal to run the street, but then you can also take it on track. And if you're not on the advanced group, you're, you know, anywhere from experience and below, these are gonna be perfect. And since we've been adding weight to the bike, now is a good time to offset that weight. They actually weigh about the same, but you have to agree that this is a much cooler looking pipe. It's a little longer, so it should give a little tiny bit of a improvement in performance. This is an area that for the track, they're coming off. We hung the exhaust out of this piece right here and not the passenger's foot peg like they did on the XR. See, I can remove the passenger foot peg on that side, but not on this one. So there you go, couple of bolts and it comes right out. And the most weight, of course, is going to be right here, but that is gonna stay for now. So where else can we save weight?